I'm Edward Hall, and I'm here in Leicester Square amongst thousands upon thousands of people for the Royal Charity premiere of arguably the biggest film of all time, Star Wars: The Phantom Menace. Episode 1 is set some 30 years before the original Star Wars, and yet, strangely, the technology of three decades previous looks better than what followed. The spacecraft are sleeker, small children can race exciting vehicles called pods, and the movie's most memorable character has a lightsaber with not one, but two dangerous ends. That quibble apart, there's a young Obi-Wan Kenobi, an even younger Darth Vader, a bloke who looks like a frog with rabbit ears, a beautiful queen who changes costume at light speed, a really good bad guy, and more special effects than you can shake a computer-generated stick at. Despite some indifferent reviews, the movie has bust the block in the United States. Now it's here, and its premiere gave the Jedi Knights from that galaxy far, far away the chance to meet a prince from the palace just round the corner. That's coming up in part two. Prince Charles will be coming down here with all the big stars of Star Wars. Now, all this public here have been here for hours on end. They're waiting for their favourites. I'm going to speak to them and see if they're excited. Are you a bit hot in there?
Not too bad. I've got a fan inside here.
You've got a fan inside? Is it going now?
Yeah.
So whereabouts is the fan based in there?
Okay. That's
a little electric light.
Can you hear that? And that's blowing into your face?
Yeah.
This is the talent of the crowd. Do me your Chewbacca. Chewbacca, ladies and gentlemen. Who's this fella? How are you?
Not too bad.
What? Did you build this yourself?
Yes, I did.
How could I guess? Now, have you seen the film? Because I think the dimensions are slightly wrong. His head is a bit head-shaped. Yours is more...
This is a caricature.
A caricature.
He's called Darth Maul.
And have you seen the film yet?
No.
When are you booked in to watch it?
Haven't booked it yet. I'm not that much of a fan.
You're not that much of a fan?
No.
Why have you done this? By now, the members of the starry Star Wars audience had begun to arrive and were drawn to the world's photographers by a force even more powerful than the Force. It's called publicity. Ronan, how are you?
Good, how are you doing, man?
I'm very, very good. Ronan, you're not in the film. Why are you here?
Because I want to be in the next one. No, I'm a big fan of Star Wars, basically. Growing up, you know, I think it was every kid's dream to be in the movie, you know?
Have you worked out a song maybe so you can try and do the songs for the next film and you're going to stand by George in the party and just hum it?
One of that, yeah. I'm going to the party tonight if you're standing rubbing shoulders, you know. Hey, get me in the next one, will you?
Like, you've seen this. What is it like?
It's great. It's great fun. It's very noisy. It's quite long.
It's amazing.
But it's got incredible special effects and it's got some wonderful ideas in it, and it's just a feast. It's a fun night out for all ages.
Now, it's that thing. It's the first episode. I imagine all the technology, and it's got to be worse. There's got to be faults with everything, hasn't there? Does that occur or not?
Well, you see a very skeletal C-3PO. I don't think we're giving anything away.
Imagine they should have sticks instead of lightsabers.
Yeah. I imagine like bits will fall off them. It'll just start breaking down. Is it like that, like a sham?
Let's be honest. If that was what the movie was like, how much fuss would people be making tonight? Let's be honest. Yeah.
Your old band, or probably Queen.
Yeah, the
now,
old band, yeah.
They've done music for Flash Gordon.
Yeah.
How does that compare, do you think? Flash Gordon and Star Wars.
Flash Gordon was slightly tongue-in-cheek, but it's the same principle. I often think, you know, I'd love to do music for a film of this type. I've just been doing some music on a film called Furia, which is a kind of a science fiction thing. It's a kind of Orwellian story. But, I mean, I'd give anything to have a go at this. Yeah, absolutely.
So, lots of A-list celebrities and hundreds more people I didn't know from Adam. However, the next arrivals needed no introduction. Well, at least not to the assembled throng of fans. Here they were, the cast members of the Star Wars family, old and new. Ladies and gentlemen, one of these is Chewbacca and one of them is R2-D2. The big question is, which?
Hello there.
Did you ever think it would come back?
Not as popular as this. No, I didn't think it would be as popular as this 25 years after the first one, but just goes to show what if you've got a good product and it sells, it goes on forever, seems to anyway.
An elegant weapon.
rather more civilized age.
Now, do you find yourself thinking, have I still got Chewbacca within me, and you keep trying to try your hand with him?
It don't bother. It doesn't bother me.
Have you still got Chewie within you?
Yes, because...
Can you just prove to me that you've just got a bit of his movement?
The chess game. I did another American station about 2 years ago. Chewie got a Lifetime Achievement Award. I hadn't worn the costume for 14 years. I put it on. And as soon as the mask went on, Chewie came back to life.
This is Anakin's mum, Pernilla.
That's right.
August. Yeah. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Now, I've got to say, you've got evil within you, haven't you?
I don't think so.
In the character, you actually give birth to what becomes Darth Vader.
That's right.
That's a tough thing, isn't it?
Yeah. But I never thought of it like that because, he's a normal little boy when I have him.
I don't want things to change.
But you can't stop the change any more than you can stop the suns from setting.
Was it maybe you didn't breastfeed him or something like that? What went wrong in Anakin's build-up?
I think we haven't seen that yet.
Ah.
It's something else, I think. I hope, because I didn't do anything
wrong. Okay. It's not your fault.
The circle is now complete. When I left you, I was but the learner. Now I am the master.
Only a master of evil, Darth.
You probably have no idea who this guy is because he doesn't actually physically, facially appear in the film. It's Jar Jar Binks, or Ahmed Best.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you very much.
Okay, now, you are the kind of like, you're the clumsy Gungan.
Mm-hmm, I am the clumsy Gungan. Even though it doesn't look like that from the suave, debonair guy you see right here.
Ah. Your point is well seen. This way, hurry.
You're a bit like a fish in it.
Kinda, more like a frog than a fish.
Like a rabbit cross between with the big floppy ears.
Yeah.
How on earth do you realise what the voice for that's going to be like?
I don't know, it just kind of like came to me. You know, I just looked at the character and it just, this is what came out of me. You know, I trusted my feelings and used the force.
The force came through.
Exactly.
Can we have a burst just to prove that you really are who you say you are?
Sure.
Hi there, Mr. Jar Jar Binks.
You're thinking, you're the people going to die?
Oh, yeah, it's a childhood dream come true. I mean, I saw the first Star Wars when my daughter was about 3 or 4, and she's here now, full-grown woman, so excited, she's almost fainting with excitement. She loves it so much. Had she not come tonight, I think she'd have died. We're so excited.
Do you think when you were sat in the Zed car, you ever felt you'd end up in a galaxy far, far away?
Yeah.
Do not defy the Council Master, not again.
I shall do what I must, Obi-Wan.
If you would just follow the code, you would be on the council. They will not go along with you this time.
You still have much to learn, my young apprentice.
It can't help but be the biggest film of all time. How does that feel?
Well, it feels good, I must say. I mean, I can't complain. It's a fantastic feeling.
So you produced the film. What is the magic of Star Wars? What's the essence that you need to get into the film to make it Star Wars?
I think primarily just to have fun. You know, in the end of the day, it's very simple. It's very basic. Every kid, every boy and girl has to leave home at some time in their life, and they've got to face a lot of anxiety. And yet, at the same time, it's an adventure, and there's obstacles. And people can see that in Star Wars. And I think they can see it very clearly because of the rich imagination that George has put on the screen. And that's what makes it just fun. You know, it's just nothing, you know, more complicated than that.
Will I ever see you again? What does your heart tell you? I hope so. Yes. I guess.
Then we will see each other again.
I will come back and free you, Mom. I promise.
Are you in line for the second one as well?
Yeah, I've already started on it. In fact, we start shooting in
Any
June.
Hints?
We're downward spiral. Obviously, now we know we've met Anakin, and we know where he's gonna become. We just don't know how and why, and that's what the next two episodes are about.
How does Anakin Skywalker develop a very deep, booming voice? Because it doesn't seem like it's gonna change at the moment.
But remember, he's not all human when we first meet him in episode 4.
Your powers are weak, old man. You can't win, Darth. If you strike me down, I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
Well, that's all for part one. Now I must implore you not to turn over to the dark side. By that, I mean any other television channel. See you in 2 minutes. Hello, welcome back to part two of the Royal Charity premiere for Star Wars Episode One, the fourth in the Star Wars series. Ray Park, you are Darth Maul. How does it feel to be possibly the biggest character in it?
Mind-blowing, you know. It's, the crowd out there are totally mad, and it's just... this is my first time to ever royal premiere or any premiere, and it's just like... It's nerve-wracking, you know, but I'm enjoying myself. I'm going to make the most of it and have a, you know, nice time, so...
Had you any idea how big this was ever going to be?
Not at all. I knew, like, when I got the job, it was the first acting role for me, but I knew it was going to be big through Star Wars and from everyone was talking on set, but I didn't realise it was going to be as big as this. I don't think anyone knew how much it would escalate in any, like, area of the Star Wars industry, so it's massive.
Now, Darth Maul, evil to the bone, really, really evil. How on earth did you create that character? Did he tell you what to do, or did you kind of, like, put your horns in your head and just go wild?
Well, just from what I saw in the storyboards and read the script and everything else, I came up with myself, you know? Like, I just wanted to be me and bring a bit of myself out, as well as the character. And I was always into cartoons and watching manga stuff and always watching Hong Kong Chinese movies, so that was like a child's fantasy. And like, and I'm a bit of a kid anyway, and we played about, and I like playing on computer games. So you just play, and the more I'd done it, the more I was in makeup, the more it was created, and the more I could do it. And George was really helpful as well. He was very good with his advice and how he wanted it, and he didn't complain. And so that made me feel comfortable, and it made me more confident to play the part.
Fantastic. Now, Darth Maul's got one really mean face. Can you just throw us a bit of Darth Maul face? What do your parents think when they see that, and they think, that's my son up there?
Well, my mum and dad saw the screening on Saturday. And they just wanted to, what my mum said to me, she just wanted to get up and say, that's my boy there, that's my son. So they're really proud, and it means a lot because they've stood by me and supported me in, like, throughout my career and everything. And it's really nice that I've come this far.
Now, I feel George Lucas gives women a very hard task in his films because you always have the most ridiculous haircuts.
But we also are the smartest and strongest characters in the movies.
I will sign no treaty, Senator.
When George showed you the wig that you had to wear, did you just think, no, that's probably going to break my back?
Yeah, and it did. It was quite an adventure wearing the whole get-up.
I suggest new leadership is needed.
Now, were you a fan of Star Wars before?
I actually had never seen the films before I got the role. And when I got the part, I sat down and watched them to figure out whether I wanted to get into this or not.
And once you'd seen all three, did you think, I've got to do this, or...?
I was really excited by the films, and I thought how wonderful it was to be part of such an event kind of movie, to be a part of something that people are so dedicated to and so devoted to and love so much.
Padme. Clean this droid up as best you can.
How does it compare to the other three?
I think it's a great film. I mean, it's not really comparable to the other films because it's a different time and we're doing different things. I mean, the technology is so much more advanced now that you know, it's superior in some ways. And, in terms of that, clearly it should be. It's 20 years later. But and it's a setup movie, so it really doesn't get into the plots like the other ones do. But people are really responding well and really have loved the movie so far.
Captain.
Your Highness.
Ready my ship.
Please, Your Majesty, stay here where it's safe.
It is clear to me now that the Republic no longer functions. I pray you will bring sanity and compassion back to the Senate.
The coolest guy in the history of the world and now the coolest man out there somewhere in space. Samuel L. Jackson, how are you?
I am excellent this evening.
Now, did you choose the night? Mace Windu?
No, I didn't. As I understand it, the story goes that when George first sat down to start writing Star Wars years ago, Mace Windu is the first character name he ever wrote. And he's just getting around to using it. Just kind of cool.
You refer to the prophecy of the one who will bring balance to the Force. You believe it's this boy?
I don't presume to.
But you do. Revealed your opinion is.
You are now Mr. Star Wars. You were Mr. Pulp Fiction, you're now Mr. Star Wars.
Well, I have a broader fan base now. You know, when I go out into the world now, there are like 7 or 8 year old kids that look at me and go, as opposed to guys that ask me, do you know what a quarter pound of a cheese is called?
Is it frightening out there? Because there's a lot of people out there and they all have got a kind of glazed look in their eye. They want part of you.
No, it was actually totally cool to get out of a car and have people like really lose it like that.
But they love you.
Well, I always wanted to be a rock star anyway, and this is the closest you can get to being that, you know, without doing a set and having everybody stand up, sing your songs, throwing their hands at you. This is it. And this is what we do, and that's what it's all about. We do this for them.
I request the boy be tested, Master.
Oh. Trained as a Jedi, you request for him,
Finding him was the will of the Force. I have no doubt of that.
Bring him before us, then.
Do you ever find yourself wandering in shops? Because there's a lot of Star Wars merchandise out there. Do you feel that's kind of part of you? And you see, if it's a bit messy, you want to rearrange it and get it all looking nice?
No, I haven't done that yet.
Have you
not? No.
If my name was on things, I'd be arranging it just so as it looked good.
Well, generally, people are calling me, asking me where my action figure is, because it kind of sells out every time they reissue it. So it's kind of a very cool thing.
Down, center on your anxieties, Obi-Wan. Keep your concentration here and now where it belongs.
But Master Yoda said I should be mindful of the future.
But not at the expense of the moment. Be mindful of the living Force, young Padawan.
Obi-Wan Kenobi, Ewan McGregor, how are you?
I'm all right, yeah.
Now, you say you're scared of the fans, or it seems like you're kind of thinking, this is too big. You're out there, there's millions of them. Is it slightly kind of weird?
All right, it's terrifying. It makes you feel it's too much to think about.
Now, you're in Star Wars. Is it something you always liked as a kid?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. No, I was a huge fan as a kid. My uncle was in all three, so I was a big fan right from 6 years old.
When you watched the film as a child, did you think, I want to be Alec Guinness?
No.
Who did you want to be as a kid?
I would like to have been Chewbacca or Princess Leia. Those were my favourites.
Did you actually try and get the Alec Guinness voice down for this?
Yeah. Yeah, or a flavour of it. You can't do a kind of impersonation, but it's got to be realistic that I become him at the end of the day, so I did what I could.
You hear that?
Yeah.
That is the sound of 1,000 terrible things heading this way.
If they find us, they will crush us, grind us into tiny pieces, and blast us into oblivion.
Ah.
Do you think that this film is as good as the first three? Do you think you've managed to get the magic?
Yeah, it's a film from now, and those were a film from then, so it's got a new magic to it, definitely. Oh, absolutely. It's mad.
You don't need any introduction for this man because he is it. George Lucas, Star Wars. George, I can't believe I've met you. There must be 1,001 people out there who'd love to be in my position. How does it feel to be the most famous man in the planet at the moment and have made probably the most influential film of all time?
Feels great. No, it's great actually to come back, and this premiere is extra special because the whole crew is here and all the people that really made the film. And you know, London is where we made it, and this is the real premiere of the movie.
This is a special one for you.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, now, it's been a while since you, because you directed the first one, then you took time out for the next two. How does it feel to get back in the seat for this one?
Do it slow. You go like that. Now you got to kick him. Felt great. You know, it was fun to be able to make a movie using new technology. It allowed me to more clearly sort of express my vision and use my imagination in ways I'd never been able to before.
Now, were you kind of thinking, or maybe the people have forgotten about Star Wars, maybe it's not going to have the same impact? I mean, are you shocked by how big it is?
Yeah, I'm surprised. I mean, I was really surprised when we did the reissue and it was received as well as it was, and that sort of was a hint of what was to come. So, you know, but you never know until you release the movie how it's going to be accepted.
Bang on schedule, the premier's special guest arrived, His Royal Highness Prince Charles. Next time he plays polo, someone will no doubt shout, "May the horse be with you." But for now, it was time for the prince to meet the rulers of the Star Wars Empire. And that was that. All that remained was the movie itself. As the prince settles down in the cinema with a hot dog and medium soft drink, what of the film is going to go and see? Well, I've been lucky enough to see it, and what can you say? It's not as bad as some of the critics might have said. However, it's not the best of the four. That said, the fight scenes are worth the cost of admission, and anyway, you're going to see it no matter what I say. So, from me and Leicester Square, good night.
And we've got exciting movie action for you in a moment here on Anglia. Gregory Peck stars as the spy who has a tiny transmitter implanted in his head. Strange but true. Don't miss The Chairman. It's coming next.
If there's a message you could give to George Lucas down that lens, what would you say?
I'd say, don't push your luck. Don't push your luck.
Don't push your luck?
No.
And what would that be referring to?
Well, I've heard it's not that good anyway.
So, you are the most reluctant Star Wars fan. You don't even like it. You've built the helmet. You think George Lucas is pushing his luck, quite frankly, with the film.
Yeah. It's all effects.
I sense much fear in you.
The boy is dangerous. They all sense it. Why can't you?
Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering.
I think it's a fantastic movie, and I think, yeah, it's, you know, let's just go there. If you're going to go and see it, go with an open mind and just go and have a fun. You know, don't take it too serious. Don't listen to what anyone says. Just go and watch it for yourself. That's the
fantastic.
Best thing.
One last thing. Can we have the move, the face, and goodbye?
Sure.